But well, Sanghi Industries, so that's the stock on our radar. The company posted, well, a rather weak set of quarter four numbers. We have Ms. Bina Engineer, the director of the company, who joins us. Hi, ma'am. Thanks so much for joining in. First things first, we've seen a big dip on the top line. That's down by closer around 20%. If you could help us out, what were your sales volumes? Why was this dip? Was it because of pricing or was it because of volumes?
Yeah, basically, it was all on account of the clinker export. If you recall, we had done substantial clinker export in the preceding quarter, that is in December quarter. So we had a large volume of about 271,000 tons of clinker sold in December quarter. Therefore, the clinker volume this quarter dropped to 34,000 tons. Which compares almost 190,000 lower compared to March 16. So clinker export to summarize, clinker export have shifted from Q4 to Q3 in this year. On the domestic sales volume, we have done 10% higher volume, and consequently, we have done 32% higher volume. So we have done 720,000 tons in domestic cement sales in this quarter, compared to 6.5 lakh in previous quarter. However, this 10% incremental volume was offset by the lower realization in prices. So typically Gujarat had lower prices in this quarter. So we had almost 10% drop in the sales price also. So therefore, net-net what you see is the loss of volume on account of clinker, which had shifted to the Q3.
Clinker exports were weak in Q4 on a quarter-on-quarter basis. Domestic cement sales went up, but it was offset by pricing pressure, right?
Absolutely.
Okay. Ma'am, what can you guide for the coming quarter in terms of volumes as well as pricing? What are the trends that you've observed in the first 2 months of this quarter?
So, in Q4 itself, we have seen significant price volatility. In January and February of 2017, the prices averaged around 207 to 210 rupees a bag in Gujarat. But by March, they had recovered back to around 230 or so, and currently they range around 250. So we have seen the recovery back to the same levels which we were experiencing in Q1 of FY17. So the prices have recovered substantially. Mm-hmm. We continue to remain the lowest cost producer among the industry, and we have registered lowest cost of sales on a per ton basis, even in Q4 compared to other industry players.
All right, ma'am, you know, the year's gone by now, things are looking up. So that's pretty good news. What kind of a sales number, cement sales number, do you target in FY18? If you could give us that number. And what kind of capacity utilization levels are you working at? And what capacity utilization levels are you looking to go to?
So we have done around 73% volume utilization during FY17.
Okay.
And we will be opening up the Mumbai and Maharashtra market in a larger way, because we are expecting the delivery of our own fleet of two ships during next couple of months. So that should stabilize. So FY18, we will have the benefit of the ship and the coastal shipping for at least about 3 to 4 months. So we should see incremental volume from Maharashtra and Mumbai market. Besides that, Gujarat market itself had degrown by about 1 or 2% last year, but we are experiencing higher sales in current year. So we
could help us out, ma'am, with a number, you know, in terms of cement sales for FY18. As you're giving us logic that there is a degrowth in Gujarat, you're looking to sell more in Maharashtra, in Mumbai as well. So what kind of a number could we work with? I think last year you did around 2.4 million tons. This year, can you do better than that? Can you do a 10% growth in terms of volumes?
So last year we did 22,000 tons of cement volume.
Okay.
So we should do better than that this year, but we don't generally come out with a guide on the number specific.
Okay. Ma'am, about the Mumbai and the Maharashtra market, where you're looking to increase your presence, what could be the expected volumes, and eventually what is the targeted revenue contribution from Mumbai and Maharashtra that you're targeting, say, by the end of FY18?
So FY18, as I say, in last 4 months, we should have the incremental volume. So we should be looking at least about somewhere closer to about 500,000 ton volume in current year.
All right, that's good news then, ma'am. If you could help us out with the EBITDA per ton for the last fiscal, that's FY17, and what are you looking to take that EBITDA per ton up from here? If I'm not mistaken, in quarter three, you had done around 550 rupees per ton.
You're right. So Q4 has been similar. Okay. But as I just mentioned, we have seen an incremental price of almost about 20%. And since our costs have not increased substantially, we should experience net of all of this price increase as additional EBITDA. So we are looking at a fairly better EBITDA number.
Right, ma'am. Final question before we let you go. What is the current debt in your books? Your finance cost has gone up substantially. If you could help us out with that number. And is Sanghi Industries looking at any kind of QIP? Are you looking at a fresh issue of shares? And the market is buzzing around with a lot of speculation. So we'd like you to clarify the same.
The debt number is around 470 crore of term debt and about 125 crore of working capital limits.
Okay.
So working capital limits, the actual drawdown keeps fluctuating. We expect an interest cost of about 75 to 80 crore rupees to continue on, at least for FY18, after which we may see a significant saving in our interest cost. And we are not going ahead with any QIP. There are no immediate plans for any QIP dilution.
Okay, thank you very much, Ms. Engineer, for joining in. That's the word from Sanghi Industries and Shilpi Cables. It's another day where it's locked in a lower circuit of about 5%. It's already fallen 80% in the last 2 or 3 months. And now we understand that the NCLT has given its approval to go ahead with the insolvency process against the company. Get into a short break. It's a heavy day in terms of earnings. Cipla.